Yes, what's up, beautiful people? I'm your girl, Soraya Hills, aka Wild and Free. And yes, you are still watching Saloon Talk on Urban TV. We're here every Sunday giving you the best Lugambo. But if you want your Lugambo, if you have questions that you have not been getting answers to, this is the show for you. Yes, we've been talking about a lot of things today, like pregnancy. For example, we've been talking about how women can prevent, how they deal with all these things. And yes, understanding now that men is another ministry, they are on section in the parliament, I think, because now that's different. When it comes to women, we are very good with communicating, we are very good with knowing what our spouses want, but when it comes to men, it's a whole other issue. Let me start with Lisa Katinao. If at all, Valentine's was yesterday, it was on Tuesday, so now if I told your Valentine gift was against the missionary and you checked and you missed your period and you're like, okay, now my Valentine gift, I'm pregnant. How would you plan to tell your man that you are pregnant? Because very many women, most of girls who are funeral guto, even though they're not going to keep it or even though they're going to talk about it, when you find out you're pregnant, the first thing that rolls in your mind is, huh? How am I going to tell Sejuko? How am I going to tell Mukisa? What would run in your mind in that moment when you find out that you're pregnant? Like, how would you plan to tell your man?
Okay, well, I feel like, as I said, because I believe like giving birth or getting pregnant is like a step in life. So I feel like first thing, I'll be very scared about it, yes. But then, because this is not something very, very, it's not a minor issue. It is a very crucial issue. And at the end of the day, I believe if you are in a relationship with someone, there is community, like you guys have to be more of like friends. You have to be comfortable talking about anything, however ugly it may be. So, and I feel that is not something I have to say over the phone or something. This is why I tell my man, I need to talk to you. There is this thing I want to talk to you about. Yeah, then because at the end of the day, I want to see how he's going to react. You know, because you're going to say it on phone or maybe through a text and then you don't know how he's going to look about you. Okay, he may be like, okay, oh my God, I know, I love it and all that. But then end of the day, I feel like you need to see how he's going to react face to face. So after finding out I'm pregnant, I would definitely want to meet my man. We sit and talk about it. I want to see, because end of the day, someone, you can see someone's reaction. You can see how they're feeling about something. Exactly. So I would want to meet him. We talk about it and I see how he reacts about it. And then from that, that's what gives you like a go over. So you maybe know, okay, this is how my man feels about this, or this is when you know what is going to happen next, or how you're really heading to something.
Before you told us you are in a committed relationship right now, obviously before you met this guy, you had, you know, some boyfriends before him. Kati, like we said, women, Tulo was a new, we always think a lot. And if you were to back me up, every woman, if you dated, let me say now, your first love, you met your first love and you guys like fell in love and you started dating, the first thing that popped out in your mind is either one, am I going to marry him? How many kids are we going to have? You start even counting the diapers that you're going to be having with this person, and then that person turns out to be not the one that you expected. So obviously, asking you this question is that Abasajia men, they do not, whether he is a good guy, whether he works in the parliament, whether he works in the ministry, whether he's a boss, whether he's a musama, they all react the same way. They don't like those things above they don't like those things, by the way, whether they are ready or they are not ready. There are some men that you when you tell you're pregnant, oh my God, we're gonna have a family, because they actually truly loved you. But if you want to know, a man doesn't love you the way you love him. He may love you, but the way you love him, if you tell a guy that, oh my God, I'm pregnant, nasoka na silika, hey, how many
the kind of point you're talking about, it happens sometimes where a man can love you and you love them, and then you really, you know, when you go in a relationship with someone, so you even talk about like, we're gonna have kids, you imagine a wedding together, a life together and all that. But as I said, this is reality. If you've gotten pregnant and then you tell a man about it, even if he may want to have kids, yeah, but for the fact that this is a changing step in your lives, okay, you've been dating, you've been having this relationship, the two of you, this is a new person coming into your life. It feels like it is a big step. So he may be excited at the moment, actually, but then after that, he's going to sit and think about the reality, the changes that are going to come with the baby, building a family and all that. This part that you guys used to talk about it and everything. At the moment, he's going to sit and think about it. I believe, like, he may not show it to you, but end of the day, he's going to sit out as a man and be like, okay, wow. Well, I'm becoming a father, and this is something he has to think about. And then also the other side where a man doesn't want to have kids, because also that part where a man really wants, like, they love you and all that, but then they don't really want to have kids with you. Because everyone has those, he may have his own reasons why, but at the end of the day, he may not want to have kids with you, or maybe he may love you, but maybe he doesn't want to have kids with you, he wants someone else, or he doesn't plan to have kids at the moment. So it happens in very many different ways, but at the end of the day, most of the times, I believe, like, we women, we meet men, and then you feel like, okay, this is my man. Then you start maybe imagining a future with him, not thinking maybe what he thinks about the whole situation, but because you feel like, okay, I love this man. He has all the qualities I think I love in a man. So you start thinking about a future with them, or you start thinking about how many babies I'm going to have with them. You imagine your wedding, you know, because end of the day, like, there's that maybe feeling the guy gives you, you know, you start imagining a lot of things. Okay, it's really crazy. Yeah. So, man, but end of the day, I believe, okay, at end of the day, as she's gonna have a baby, I believe that is a whole blessing. At end of the day, we all, like, who wouldn't want to have a kid? Like, kids are adorable.
But who doesn't want to have a kid? Girl? Your man is there.
You know, yeah. It's beautiful, by the way. It's beautiful building a family with someone you love, having babies. Yeah, kids are adorable.
Single mothers, by the way, like I said, growing up with a single mom, and I have siblings who are young. My sister is 6 years right now. So basically, I practically almost raised her. You know, these things of Zuke, you know, 3 a.m., you have to breastfeed. Because if you have a man, a caring man, most one has decided to be in your life, he can be like, oh baby, no, you sleep, let me go take care of the baby. You know, it's good to have someone with you with the whole pregnancy. Let me come to the mother to be. How was it your time when you told your man that actually in Dirubuto, like, what was his reaction and what was in your mind at that time? Did you expect him to actually tell you Mwasiragala, or did you actually believe that he was gonna be there for you?
There was nothing like Siragala, because we've been in so much love since day one. So everything was an excitement to us. The fact that is his first baby too, my first baby, the first grandbaby, the first grandbaby on the other side too. So it was a whole new thing to us. We were both excited. I just don't know, but it was.
We can even see the joy on your face.
Yeah.
But do you
we
think
expected it because, I mean, we...
Do you think it's a different story if at all, let me say, the person you love right now, your hubby, if at all he had kids before this one? Do you think it would have been a different story? Because I feel like it would have been a very different story.
No, but me, I believe in love. So even if he had kids, I still believe he would be happy for this one too, because for someone that has had kids already, maybe he wouldn't be that excited like this one.
Or if actually not even that. Yes, everybody's character is different. I'm such a little item moving into their whole. No, like I'm trying to be diverse. Even men, even boys, there are people actually who have grown up like, there are men out there that have been raised like in a very harsh life, and when they end up getting a girlfriend, they be like, oh, may I have trauma? Okay, even if you have trauma, even if you have trauma, and at all, and your girlfriend tells you, and you're not ready, and your girlfriend tells you, okay, Nidibuto, don't want to. You see, men keep forgetting women have feelings, and we are very, very emotional. If you're a man, and men, you have to understand this, by the way, whether you're ready, whether you're young, whether you're not. If a woman tells you, or if a lady, if your girlfriend tells you she's pregnant, even if it's your first baby, even if it's not, you have to understand that women have a lot of feelings. And more so now, she has found out she's pregnant. Everything is here. Her family, her words.
We should stop saying, Smanya, the man is young, what? If you're young, then why are you even having sex in the first place? If we're talking about sex, we are dealing with adults. So if you're a grown up, you went through the same procedures, you removed your pants, you removed her pants. If you're not ready, then stop having sex.
At least,
a man denies pregnancy. If a man is like me, I'm not ready, then you should...
You know, there are both men who actually tell you, I'm not ready for the pregnancy, and then you'll be like, okay, for you, you go against your all, and you're like, fine, come on, come on, kuze, wanna come, and then after they come back, God, I don't know what I do to you. And I'm sorry to catch you a little bit. Let us run to another commercial break. When we come back, the conversation is still running. Guys, please go down to our social media platform and engage in the conversation because it is fire on fire.